Hey everybody, dutchsinse here. 6.05 p.m. Central Time on Friday, October 25th, 2013. And we're looking at Earthquake 3D here, which is a USGS feed of the most recent earthquakes. And you can see today, a 7.6 originally, now downgraded to a 7.2, struck off the shores of eastern Japan. And there was a tsunami warning issued, which has since been lifted, no sizable wave. Now this takes me back, guys, to 2011, and you have to think back 2 years when we saw the flurry of earthquake activity building up to the large 9.0 that happened in Japan, which killed thousands of people in the massive tsunami that occurred. And before the 9.0, there was a 7.2 in roughly the same area that we're seeing now, maybe 100 miles west of where the current 7.2 occurred. Maybe just a little southwest, but roughly the same exact area. And in 2011, when the 7.2 struck, it produced a small wave about 2 feet tall that came into several harbors along the eastern coast of Japan.
かなり揺れました。今、東京のスタジオも、ライトが揺れているのが。体感はなかったんですけど、今、中継の映像ですけれども、気仙沼港、海面がですね、大きくこう、漁船が揺れているという状況が入ってきました。これは津波ですね。はい、生中継の映像、おそらくですね、津波の第1波ではないかというふうに見られるんですが、 かなりこの気仙沼港、現在の映像ですが、海面が揺れて、そして漁船がですね、その波によって揺れているのが見受けられます。ちなみに宮城県は、予想到達時刻は正午ちょうど50センチということなんですが、現在12時7分30秒ですけれども、かすかにですね、海面が、やや波紋が広がっているというのが見受けられます。現在の気仙沼港の 中継の映像をご覧いただいています。やや波立っていると、それほど高い波ではありませんが、やや波紋が広がっているというところですね。余震の心配もありますので、引き続き確かに波が来てますね。波立ってますね。繋がれているこの漁船がですね、上下に動いているのが確認できます。それほど高さではないようには見受けられます。 海岸や河口の近くにいる人は直ちに高台や高いビルなど安全な場所に避難してください。現在津波注意報が出ています。海岸や河口の近くにいる人は直ちに高台や高いビルなど安全な場所に避難してください。注意報が解除されるまでは海岸や河口に絶対に近づかないでください。現在宮城県気仙沼市、気仙沼港の映像です。
I would say 7.2 again in roughly the same area, and the flurry of activity that's been happening there over the last several days, over the last 7 days, you can see all the 4 and 5.0 earthquakes stretching right up along the eastern coast of Japan, going up into the Kuril Islands, Kamchatka, Russia, up here. So we do need to watch. We have to watch this area for the next several days going into the next week, and that's due to the movement around the planet, as well as 2 X-class flares, and what are we at, 7 or 8 M-class flares over the last 24 to 48 hours. And to see that, let me take you over to my radar page. These are all live streaming feeds that we've put together here. And down towards the bottom of the list, we've got all our solar feeds. And this is just a small sampling. You can see the other links down below. But you can see all this activity here goes up into the X-class flares that are here from today. But these are all M-class. Okay, and several of these are 2 and 3 of them at once. So it goes up to an M and then spikes up to a borderline X and then back down to a mid-M, another mid-M, mid-M, XX, MM. So we're looking at a large amount of activity coming from the sun. And we know that the incoming solar flare activity, as well as particles ejected from the sun, do have an effect, geomagnetic effect, on planet Earth. Now, over the last several days, guys, I've been absent. I've been working my regular job trying to make ends meet, so I haven't been able to do the updates that I would like to do. There's been other activity since the 6.5 that happened here in Baja last week, almost 7 days ago. We had a 6.8 down here at the South Mid-Atlantic Ridge, north of Antarctica. We were expecting that. All the 4 and 5.0 activity that was happening here at the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, if you guys watched the Robo News update, Robo told you to watch those areas. And again, those areas have shown further large-scale movement in the near term. And that's because of the incoming solar activity as well as the geologic unrest occurring around the plate already happening from the plate fracture over here at the Indo-Australian plate. I'll put some links down below to earthquake feeds. You can come to the radar feed here, and if you just keep scrolling down, there's some links down at the very bottom of the page that take you to more links. So you can go to these different links here, and it's got a picture of a globe with the earthquakes on it. Click on that, and you've got all the North American links, Midwest links, West Coast, and then we also have international. It's not a full list, but it definitely will fill the void.